Hi YouTubers, this is Beth and I am back with some very specific examples of things that I've done to successfully stay on target with my Christmas gift shopping for my kids, family, friends, and teachers and things. One of the main things that I like to do is set up ahead of time that you want to sign up for the email lists of the stores that you and your family especially like. If you know that your kids or your family members like XYZ or ABC types of stores, sign up for their email lists. A lot of stores will have points programs, VIP shopping programs, gifts with purchase programs. They'll send you coupons in your regular mailbox or your email. And when you're setting up the email, make a rule. See if you can find out how to do this. It's pretty easy and self-explanatory in most email programs. Is set up a rule so that your email will filter your advertisements into one advertisement folder. That way, the ads are not clogging up your regular daily use email, and you're not getting tempted because you're only going into that folder when you decide that you are ready to go do some specific shopping trip online. A lot of companies will also have apps in your phone, which is pretty handy. You saw that I went to Kohl's. I went to the brick and mortar store, but I used an app in my phone to make use of the Thanks to You Rewards program they have. So that's like a good example. Another example of something I did last year that was really successful with my kids is I signed up for the Scholastic Books program online. That is the company that makes educational books that is typically sold to the school market. Your kids may bring home flyers and things for that if you're having kids in elementary school. And I do have kids all the way from elementary school, middle school, high school, and beyond. So I get an email every once in a while from Scholastic. And then occasionally, over the course of the year, they'll run these like grab bag jackpot boxes. It averages out that each book ends up costing about $1 a book. But they'll send you a book. It's like 20 books or something like that. Or 20 or 30 books, I think you can choose. You tell them what age group your kid is in. I ordered two different age group boxes. And then your kid gets all these new types of books. They're brand new books, and it's a great variety. You're bound to find some things in there that your kid likes, and it helps to fill out their Christmas gifts. Something else, speaking of books, is I went to my used bookstore. We have a really tremendous, big, very popular, always crowded bookstore, used bookstore in our area, and they also sell new things. So I went to the DVD section because my kids love DVDs, watching DVDs in the van when we're driving around. I found some brand new, still sealed in the original shrink wrap, Christmas DVDs. Well, they were at a seriously discounted price, and I bought several of them. So brand new items, keep an eye out. You never know. You might be in a used bookstore and find brand new stuff. Something else that I know people like to do, and I have done this before, and I've heard several people mention this to me, is use your credit card rewards points for something Christmas related. Maybe you want to trade it in for gift cards. Some of them offer bonuses depending on which gift cards you choose. Sometimes you can trade them in for items. The main thing though, don't do this if you're not dedicated to paying off your credit card every single month. I pay off my credit cards every single month down to zero so I don't get any finance charges. That's the only way to take this to the next level and make it work to your advantage. If you're dedicated, you can squeeze some extra dollars out of your usage on a credit card during the year. I'm checking my list to make sure that I've got all the things pointed out on this video that I wanted to hit, the high points. Something else that I like to do, speaking of gift cards, is keep an eye out. Places like Kroger Grocery Store and some other restaurants and different places will offer bonuses if you buy your gift cards through them. So maybe a restaurant might say, okay, buy $25 gift card and get a $5 gift card back for yourself. And you give that $25 gift card as a gift. Maybe it's to your babysitter or to another person who has meant a lot to you and your family. So also with Kroger, they tend to do a 4x gas points program for gift card purchases. So if you buy a $100 gift card somewhere, you're getting 400 gas points, which can really add up if you fill up your tank there at their gas station. Something else is buy classic winners. When you get to the end of your list and you're filling things out of things that you're buying for your kids or others, I like, especially for the kids, buy classics. They're classics for a reason. Specifically, every year for my younger kids in elementary school, I know I'm buying Play-Doh. I know I'm buying Crayola crayon art packs. They make these neat little coloring books at the dollar store that I can buy that are Crayola brand, Crayola good crayons, and little coloring books, good name brands. My kids love those. And then art supplies and Legos, little Lego kits and things like that, my kids love. That's just a very few examples. I have more things to say, but I don't want to make a video that's too long for you. In the meantime, I would love it if you would click the thumbs up on my video, make some comments, let me know what you're looking for, ideas, questions, or whatever, as far as what types of tips you're looking for me to share with you. If you click the subscribe button, that'll make me really happy and make my day. Anyway, a subscribe button right down here. Okay, so anyway, it's been a lot of fun talking with you guys, and I'll talk to you later with more ideas in the next video.